A spectrum means that we're going to take some time history, and this time history, we're going to decompose it using a Fourier transform into a set of sinusoids. And we can then look at these sinusoids, you know, they have a certain amplitude and they have a certain frequency associated with them. So you can see the frequency domain representation of this data, where you can see the amplitude and frequencies of the individual sinusoids that make up this time signal. For a given time domain signal, and this is kind of key to the whole Fourier transform, there's only one set of sine waves that sum up to give you that signal. So it's a unique set of sine waves, right? In other words, there's like a one-to-one correspondence between the frequency and the time domain when you use the Fourier transform to go between. And it's helpful to look in the frequency domain for a given time signal because we can see the constituent components. And I always kind of joke, it's very useful. We know who to blame for a given noise or vibration problem. We can see like, oh, 60 hertz is really big. I know that's the compressor. They're to blame for the problem. The fan, which is running at 180 hertz, that's very low amplitude. I know it's not to blame. So I pick on the compressor person and not on the fan person, for example. Let's actually try it, see what happens. So I got the software here. And let's start with a sine wave. So I got the sine waves here, okay? And I put the same sine wave in the top and the bottom. If I was to kind of zoom in a little bit, I think you can see it looks like a nice sine wave, right? Let's say I take this sine wave here, click on the button here for Fourier transform, and it just does a Fourier transform, no parameters, no window, or anything like that. I now get a FFT, and I can say, oh, okay, this sine wave must have been right around 100 hertz or so, right? Yeah. And then if I click on this again, I'm going to hit the Fourier transform button, and it'll do the inverse Fourier transform. Will that look like this original sine wave? All right, let's see. I think it's looking like it. I was going to maybe zoom in a little bit here on both. Yeah, it looks pretty good, pretty identical. So we can take data from the time domain to the frequency domain and back through the Fourier transform, get the same result. But a sine wave is pretty simple. Should we do something maybe a little more complex? Yeah, I got a folder here called complex. I think it has a complex signal in it. Got that the top. At the bottom here, I'll hit FFT. Oh, now this guy's got like some noise all across the band. And it looks like there's, you know, 100, 104 or so frequencies in it. So, all right, I'm going to hit the FFT button and go back again. And what do you think? Does it look like the original?
It does.
That's exactly the point that we wanted to make. We're hopefully demonstrating that, you know, there's this ability to go back and forth. And one of the key things that, you know, you can kind of forget about sometimes if you're not careful. If I go back here we showed the spectrum, right, of these sine waves. But I only showed the amplitudes. But to really go back to the original signal, besides the amplitudes and the frequencies that these things occur at, what else do I need, Charles?
The phase.
Yeah, I need the phase. And that means, yeah, like in this example, I got two sine waves, a red one and a blue one. They're the same amplitude. But when I do the Fourier transform, and I guess the spectrum is just the raw or straight up Fourier transform, you can see amplitudes come out the same, but the phase is different. And that's how it knows how to reconstruct that properly back in the time domain. It's got to have that phase information to do so. When I was showing this here, I was, if I had that sine wave, I was only showing the amplitudes when I did the Fourier transform. But if I grab this sine wave and I do the FFT, there's a amplitude and a phase. And I used a plot here called a Bode plot to show both at the same time. So that was key to being able to go back and forth, even though we didn't see the phase in this regular front-back display. It was still using it behind the scenes, if you will, to show that. Well, key takeaways, any time domain signal can be described with a unique set of sinusoids, and these sinusoids have a specific amplitude, frequency, and phase, and no information is lost. We can move back and forth.